Welcome to the fourth section in our series on lipids. This section will be covering lipoproteins. This is a diagram of a lipoprotein, and you can see the phospholipid bilayer, where we talked about phospholipids acting as emulsifiers, as allowing lipids to travel in an aqueous environment. We have the phospholipid bilayer with proteins, and then in here, this is a representation of cholesterol and triglycerides. So lipoproteins are carriers of lipids. Now you know lipoproteins as LDL and HDL. LDL being the low-density lipoprotein and known as the bad cholesterol, whereas HDL is high-density lipoprotein and known as the good cholesterol. I think one of the key points is that these are lipoproteins. They're actually not cholesterol. I will refer to them as the good and bad cholesterol because that's how everybody refers to them. Even within the medical field, we'll talk about good and bad cholesterol. But I want you to know that these are carriers of cholesterol. Now, the reason LDL is titled the bad cholesterol is because a high level of LDL in the blood is associated with an increased risk of heart disease. The HDL, which is your high-density lipoprotein, is good because when there is a higher level of HDL, it's associated with a decreased risk of heart disease. So what you want on your blood lipid profile, and this has been historically what you want, is a low LDL and a high HDL. Now, there's some new research that has shifted the way we think about this, and this is not in your textbook, but I do want you to know this, to be aware of this, is that LDL, which is what is measured in our bloodstream, it's a lipoprotein in our bloodstream that carries triglycerides and cholesterol. It's not something that you eat. There are two types. There is a small dense LDL and a large buoyant LDL. The small dense LDL is actually more atherogenic, whereas the large buoyant is less atherogenic. Now what that means is that the large buoyant LDL has a lower chance of causing heart disease. And I don't want to say cause because we can't really say that LDL causes heart disease, but it is associated with a lower rate of heart disease, whereas a small dense tends to be associated with a greater rate of heart disease. So they think that the small dense LDL has a greater potential for contributing to heart disease. Now this is interesting because historically we have said that both saturated fats and trans fats will elevate LDL, and we want to avoid them because higher LDL is associated with heart disease. Therefore, saturated and trans fats are linked with heart disease. What we're finding out now is that what raises the small dense LDL are the refined carbohydrates that I've been talking about so far this semester. We reviewed last week all those refined carbohydrates. They're more atherogenic. And these are going to raise the small dense LDL. Saturated fat, on the other hand, is less atherogenic and it raises large buoyant. So if your overall LDL is high, you may not know if it's a small dense or large buoyant. If it's higher in the small dense LDL, then that means you have a greater risk of heart disease, or it's associated with a greater risk of heart disease. The test to decipher these LDL fractions is not commonly done. It actually is a little bit expensive. So unless you're at risk for heart disease or have a really high LDL, then your doctor probably wouldn't order it and your insurance may not cover it. So this is something that's a little bit new and you may not have heard of it before, and you definitely won't read it about it in your text. Now the reason I mention it is because we're finding out that Saturated fat may not be as bad for heart disease as we thought, and this is one of the reasons. Also, there are different types of saturated fat, whether it's plant-based saturated fat, animal saturated fat, or processed saturated fats. So my recommendation to you, as it has been the entire semester, is to avoid all processed fats, saturated or unsaturated. And really limit the refined carbohydrates. Remember, this is the cereals. This is all the cereals and the pastas and the breads. It's not just cookies and crackers and snack food. So I just want to finish here with the kind of general rule that saturated fat will increase LDL, but it's going to increase a large buoyant LDL, which still can contribute to heart disease, but just not as much as the small dense LDL, which is raised from refined carbohydrates, and trans fats. So trans fats are also more atherogenic, and we'll get into trans fats in a later section. This is the end of our section on lipoproteins.